the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf alayhi salam, when he came out of prison, as a result of interpreting dreams. And when he was brought before the king, not only did he establish his innocence, he actually presented his resume. Yusuf alayhi salam actually asked for the job. He wasn't given the job, he asked for it himself. And he didn't just ask for it, he said, here's why you should hire me. He said, اجعلني على خزائن الأرض, which basically means, literally means, install me upon the treasures of the land. What that means in simple English is, make me the treasurer. I would like to be the treasury secretary of Egypt. And here's why, إني حفيظ عليم. First of all, I'll guard this duty. I'll take it seriously. I won't sleep on the job. I won't have lame duck sessions in my Congress. I'm going to be on the job, I'll take care of it, I'll be honest about it. And I know what I'm doing, alim. Because the guys around you are a bunch of idiots. They're going to destroy this problem, and it's going to create a fiscal crisis, and people are going to die. So I need to take care of business. I'm letting you know I'm qualified to handle this. Leadership is about confidence. Leadership is about confidence. Too much confidence and you have arrogance. If you have too much confidence, you have arrogance. That's why before you have leadership, the discussion we began with today was understanding that you and I are abd to Allah, slaves to Allah, which is the lowest position you can have. But when you are a abd of Allah, then you realize Allah, this is not your talent, Allah has given you certain talents. Allah has given you certain abilities. And it is your God-given responsibility as a slave of Allah to use those talents to the best of your ability. And if that means you have to take a position of leadership, well, that means you have to take a position of leadership. If nobody's going to stand up and take the job, you have to take the job. That is not arrogance, that is actually being true to what Allah has given you. Arrogance is when you are obsessed with holding your title and you can't let it go. The motivation Yusuf alayhi salam has for leadership is because it's going to save lives, not because he likes treasury secretary, minister of treasuries. He doesn't like the title. He wants to save lives. That's true leadership. Leadership not for its own sake, for the sake of providing a service. If you truly believe you have something to offer in leadership, go for it. And some of you, Allah has created you natural born leaders. Kids cut class when you cut class in school. You're a leader. You know, people go to the restaurant that you suggest. They don't go to any other restaurant. You're a leader. Allah has given you that naturally. You have a personality, it's charismatic. People listen to you, they do what you say. You have an influence over the opinions of others. You are a leader. And some of you are not leaders. Some of you are extremely good followers. You guys are machines. Amazing. And you know what? You should acknowledge that, accept that as a gift from Allah, because the world doesn't just work on leaders. The world needs good followers. Some of you are neither leaders nor followers. Those of you need to pick a lot of istighfar. So you'll find yourself. Okay? Because you need to do something. You need to fit somewhere. You know? But now that the two qualities that Yusuf alayhi salam describes of himself that justify his leadership role are Hafidh and Alim. You will guard that responsibility. You will take care of it seriously. It is something you will protect. And second, you know what you're doing. So sincerity is it's implied. It's obviously there. If you're a slave of Allah, sincerity doesn't even have to be talked about because it's understood. That's the foundation anyway for all actions. But on top of that, one, you have a very serious attitude towards the job. Two, you actually know what you're talking about. When it comes to that job, you know what you're talking about. So religious fervor, you're extremely religious, you're extremely righteous, you're extremely pious, you're a hafiz of Quran, that doesn't mean you're a leader. That does not mean you're a leader. You're an extreme zahid, you make dua for hours and hours and hours and hours, that does not mean you're a leader. Because leadership requires one, seriousness with the job, and two, knowledge of the job.